This fight brought to you by RCTI. A measured first few seconds. Explosions could happen at any moment. The challenger in the black shorts, in the army fatigues, the champion, Bigdash.
Aung La told me that he feels that Bigdash keeps his head in a stationary position and it exposes a huge hole so that maybe he can capitalize with that big right hand of his.
He certainly does have a big right hand. They both have power in those fists.
Bigdash wants to outwork Aung La and just really put pressure on him because he doesn't feel he's conditioned for this particular fight.
The first offensive move of the night, that kick, a scything kick to the stomach from the Burmese fighter. It's a measured start, isn't it, from both men. Caution is the watchword. Not sure that Bigdash has really thrown much at all at this stage yet. He's got plenty of time. Don't forget, five-minute rounds in this one.
Bigdash has landed two pretty significant leg shots. That's really only been strikes that he's thrown. Hasn't really thrown his hands, hasn't really set up anything.
Well, that knee landed to the side of the rib cage there. Bigdash looks in tremendously good shape, doesn't he? Really carries this weight extremely well.
Aung La looks very relaxed, good movement, bobbing nice and light on his feet. Bigdash looks a little stationary, a little flat-footed. Nice body shot there from Bigdash, though.
Really dug it in, didn't he, to the midriff. Super left hand. Not a punch you see so very often in mixed martial arts. Left hook to the body. That one came in a forward motion rather than outside in. What a slapping noise that made. Not sure that it connected too much with the head. There was a lot of arm in that, but that one got through to the stomach. Very accurate work there from the Bigdash feet.
That clinch from Bigdash. Aung La is able to push it off, moving nice and relaxed, pushing forward, controlling the center of the cage.
Neither man willing to get overly excited here. Waiting for their moment, biding their time. This one certainly is a marathon, not a sprint. 25 minutes is a long time to stand in front of an opponent.
Nice right hand there from Aung La. This is his 30th fight, so he's definitely been in there with some very high-level competition. So this is no, you know, new thing for him. He's very relaxed and composed, but the champion is the less experienced fighter.
Yeah, 1 year older, but Aung La and Sung vastly more experienced.
A little bit of gamesmanship there from Bigdash. The crowd seems to get behind him on that one.
1:30 left in this opening round. Yuji Shimada calling for action. The crowd around us just gaping open mouth. You dare not take your eyes off this one. We've seen the power that both men have exhibited in contests gone by. 70 seconds left in the opener. Spins. No greens.
1 minute left in the first round. 1 minute.
Aung La and Sung, if anything, is the one that's moving forward. Neither fighter really looking to gain much ground. Final 40 seconds.
The leg kick from both fighters, there's that spinning attack again. I like how he set it up with the inside leg kick. He went after the inside leg kick, stepped forward. That helped set him up without the high disguise, that spinning back kick a little bit better. Didn't really telegraph it as much like Bigdash just did there.
Intriguing, fascinating, somewhat tepid this opening round though. You're just waiting for that big explosion to come. Final 10 seconds, there's a kick to the body and some heavy blows coming just in the dying moments of this opening round. Big elbow from Bigdash and another one. And Aung Lahn Sung certainly had his bell rocked just before the bell at the side of the cage signaled the end of the opening round.
That seems to be where Bigdash has the biggest advantages, from that clinch position. He's able to control the distance, and there's that spinning side kick that was landed by Aung Lahn Sung. He set it up really nicely. That one didn't quite land as effectively. Bigdash says, no big deal, let's do it again. Rich, break that one down for him.
This is almost dead even round. These two guys, they're just kind of picking at each other. I really like how relaxed Aung Lahn looks in this round. Like, his timing just is really good. Bigdash looks quite rigid, so it's going to be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these two make coming out. But this is one where you're just going to have to kind of count the punches. You can see a little bit of red mark on Big Dash's forehead, so a few of those punches have gotten through from Aung Lahn. Aung Lahn has a nice little knot on his right temple as well. But if you were to look at the punch stats, I believe that Aung Lahn has probably landed a couple more punches. So when I say he has the lead, I'm talking as marginally as
it's
possible.
It's a sliver
that I can say.
I'm betting that that welt on the right-hand side of Aung Lahn Sung's forehead came from the exchange in the dying seconds of that first round. Elbows flying in, forearms from Vitaly Bigdash. But Rich remarking on how composed the Burmese fighter looks. The same could be said for Vitaly Bigdash, certainly.
Bigdash looks a little bit more relaxed this round. He's got his head moving a little bit. He's a little bit lighter.
He's looser, isn't he? Took the right hand there, though.
That was a sneaky right hand landed by Aung Lahn. Both fighters exchange leg kicks again. Those seem to be the most significant strikes for both fighters, is attacking the legs.
Just kind of ducked underneath those punches as they came at the same time, and they became glancing blows. Bigdash had a little mop of his brow just to make sure that there was no damage there. There isn't anything.
Man, Bigdash throws some heat with those kicks, huh?
Now he's getting to work. Brings in Aung Lahn Sung's head and then the knee to the body. Pressed up against the cage now.
See, inside the clinch is where Bigdash can possibly drain some of the energy out of Aung Lahn. He's going to be able to, you know, make Aung Lahn work a little bit harder, because in the stand-up exchanges, Aung Lahn Sung's very relaxed.
Now, three times there we saw hand in the face, elbow to the face from Aung Lahn Sung, and at some stage it looked as if there may have been a stray finger in the eye. Good spirit, good sport. Vitaly Bigdash isn't going to make a big meal of it, and we resume without much of a delay at all.
Yeah, with these open-fingered gloves, it's very dangerous to reach out and try to touch your opponent's head. You're usually just trying to create distance.
Right hand from Bigdash there caught the Burmese python. Aung Lahn Sung showing us that he's very durable. Looks like he's got a solid chin. He'll need one. He's got a big frame and a big neck. Well manufactured to take these big punches, but no one can withstand huge punches all night long.
Looks like Bigdash is trying to bait him in. He's trying to get him unlocked to try to, you know, initiate some sort of exchange so he can counter with that big kick that he's throwing. He's setting up that right kick quite nice.
Snappy, isn't it? Boss. Sends it with speed. Left jab from Aung Lahn Sung, takes a knee to the head and then gets flung towards the cage wall.
Yeah, he's trying to bait Aung Lahn in so he can initiate a clinch, possibly go for that Muay Thai clinch, the palm, and start dropping some knees, and he likes that elbow as well.
Seems to me that Bigdash fancies himself as a stronger man in the clinch, body to body. We'll see.
See, he's just able to land a little bit more of the strikes from the clinched position. A little bit stronger, he looks like he's setting up a knee here. Yep.
Again, Aung Lahn Sung's hand in Big Dash's face. Look for him to perhaps throw that forearm in. There it is again, exactly what he was doing before. And again.
It's a nice short elbow.
Keep it going. Boss, take care.
Big Dash with the left hand flush in the face, goes downstairs to the body as well. Both men working hard on the cage wall. Inside the final 100 seconds of this second round, Yuji Shimada wants them to the center of the cage. Big Dash looks up at himself on the big screen. Satisfied with his work so far, it's close.
Both fighters are conserving their energy very well. They're not expending a lot. They're not getting overly dramatic in either attacks. They're not really exchanging big flurries. They're very composed, very relaxed. Big Dash seems to be relaxed a little bit, you know, more in this round than he was in the previous one.
Yeah, that's very much been the story of the first 9 minutes. Both men very much ready and prepared to go the full 25.
Watch out. No headbutting. No headbutting.
Many would tell you it's unlikely to get that far. And there we are again. Hand on the face, elbow. From Aung La and Sung.
Green fight.
Takes some punishment to the body and a right hand to the chin. And a left hand to the jaw as well. Big Dash backs off, knowing that he's done some good work there on the cage wall. Aung La and Sung does not look phased.
30 seconds left in the second round.
Final half minute of the second round. Right hand from Aung La and Sung. Didn't quite land with all the heaviness he wanted.
Again, Big Dash is able to turn Aung La over, press him up against the cage. Really just landing these short strikes, not really doing a lot of damage, but both fighters are scoring in this position.
Well, that's a good, nice elbow, wasn't it? They're both working hard from that position. The Burmese fighter perhaps slightly more so, and I think that'll probably tot up on the scorecards. He's working hard inside there.
Yeah, very good round for both fighters. You know, we see a lot of action in the clinch. Aung La's dropping those short elbows, and there's a little bit of flurry. See, but that's where Big Dash is doing the best work. He's really controlling the clinch. He's able to press Aung La over, and then he's still keeping active with the short strikes. Nice little exchange there to end the round. Rich, how would you break that round down?
Well, I'll tell you what the interesting thing here is that you can tell how strong Big Dash is every time they clinch. He's like turning Aung La, putting him into the cage, and I mean, not just turning him into the cage, but almost throwing him into the cage. The lead that Aung La had, according to me, at the end of the first round was very marginal, but Big Dash has done some really good work with his dirty boxing, the elbows from the clinch. They're both landing shots, but from the clinch, I believe Big Dash is landing way more. At the end of this round, I give Big Dash the lead. Not a big lead, but he's in the lead.
It's close, yeah, it's close. But Rich gives it to Big Dash so far. That's after 10 minutes with 15 to come. Remember, it's not round by round scoring. We look at the whole fight when we decide who the winner is.
Big kicks thrown by Big Dash.
The spinning kick connected that time, but only around the shoulders. Oh, that's a big one, and that rocked Aung La and Sung, no question. Follows up with the right hand, and he has enough presence of mind to go for the trip, Aung La and Sung. But he's taken a lot of punishment on his back now. Punches coming in, there were elbows too. There's a lot of unanswered blows to the head now, but Aung La and Sung gets to his feet with tremendous strength, almost goes down with the trip. No question that it should be stopped at this stage because Aung La and Sung is in full control, although he certainly was rocked. Strong enough to get back up to his feet. What strength, Mitch.
What composure shown by Aung La and Sung to keep his wits about him when he just got rocked. Big Dash landed some huge shots there as he attempted to finish the fight, but how composed was Aung La and Sung there?
Reminders of that tremendous fight that Big Dash had with Igor Swirid for a moment there. Exchange of blows that don't really come that close to finishing the fight because these two men are so durable and strong.
Now, this is a very smart move on Aung La's part. He's keeping the posture down of Big Dash. Now he's going to able to regain his wits, make sure his head is clear. But Big Dash is trying to fog it up with those elbows.
His head bounced off the canvas, and there's some blood dripping on the canvas, as you can see. You can bet that's coming from Aung La and Sung's head. The sharp point of the elbow will do the damage. Looks like it's on the left-hand side of the Burmese fighter's face.
To
see exactly where the damage is. It could be the ear, it could be just on the upper cheek there, but Vitaly Big Dash will go to work and see if he can cause any more damage or possibly even finish the fight. But for the first time, Aung Le Unsung looks now as if he's got a bit of an uphill struggle. More than capable of coming back, but it's difficult now. Another big forearm coming in from Vitaly Bigdash.
Aung Le Unsung is very tricky off his back. You can see his hips pivoting from side to side, looking for any opening that he's had. But Bigdash is landing some huge elbows just to kind of stifle the ground attack of Aung Le. Active guard, he's trying to swivel his hips from side to side, looking for a possible sweep or submission. But Bigdash is following his hips as Aung Le tries to pivot his hips out. You can see Bigdash kind of follows the hips with him. So he's not able to create any angles.
Elbows and forearms from Bigdash. There it is again. Two very big elbows to the top of the head. Aung Le Unsung really is taking quite a battering from that left elbow. There's another attempt. Didn't land flush that time. Right hand comes down. Okay. Aung Le Unsung is in trouble now, Mitch. He's got so much to do.
Time stop.
Now, Yuji Shimada calls for a break in the action. I think he wants perhaps the doctors to have a look at Aung Le Unsung's face, and that seems an eminently sensible move.
I think the cut is affecting his vision. He's wiping his eyes. He's trying to get clear, especially when you're in the ground, when it's flowing into the eye.
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to see very well.
And, of course, your arms aren't free to wipe it away, so you're fighting blind. So, Vitaly Bigdash on the cusp of really taking control of this fight now. Aung Le Unsung.
Timeout. We've got an injury timeout, Rich. How is this going to work?
Well, this is a different kind of timeout here because they actually brought the doctors in to look at the cut and assess that. So this isn't a five-minute timeout where there's a foul or anything like that. The doctor's going to assess the cut. It didn't look like the cut was actually obstructing the vision, but the blood was. So now that they have his face cleaned up, restarting the fight.
They're going to get into the position they were in, or something approximating it, when Yuji Shimada called for a break in the action.
Keep going.
So, the Burmese fight has been cleaned up. He's got his vision back, but for how much longer? You can bet that Vitaly will go to work with those elbows and forearms once again. You're seeing evidence right there. Final 50 seconds of this third round, and then it's the championship rounds. If we get that far, there's a lot of damage can be done in these final 40.
Bigdash is just so strong. He's just holding unlined position, and as soon as he creates a little bit of space, those big elbows start coming down.
Another huge pair of blows, one from the left elbow, one from the right fist. Then he works the body, comes back upstairs to the temple.
This round has completely changed the fight. Bigdash has done so much damage, and it all started with that big head kick.
That sharp point of the elbow has done so much damage. When Aung Le Unsung's corner get him on his stool, they realize they've got a lot of work to do to patch him up. His head looks clear, though.
There's that beautiful left high kick of Bigdash. Aung Le was a bit rocked. He was able to keep his composure here. These are big shots being landed by Bigdash. He gets back up to his feet and helps regain his composure, but then some of these elbows that were landed are just so punishing. The way he creates a little bit of space and just slides into that elbow, how do you have that one scored, Rich?
That round, obviously all Bigdash. The head kick that he landed there scored some internal damage when it wobbled Aung Le. All the ground and pound that he did with the takedown landed a lot of cumulative damage, so he's scoring in the higher categories. He's extended his lead tremendously. At this point in time, 15 minutes in, Bigdash.
What I can tell you just from looking at Aung Le Unsung's face in between rounds there is that the damage seems to be underneath the eyes. Now, as Mitch pointed out earlier on, when he's on his back, very likely that the blood would run into his eye. When he's standing up, not so much. So in the stand-up, he should have relatively clear vision. That, of course, is only one aspect of damage done to your face. Vitaly Bigdash will see that, and he will take encouragement from it. Aung Le Unsung knows that after that costly third round, He needs to do something a little bit special here in the fourth.
Will he get the opportunity? Goes right back to his strengths, gets the takedown and starts delivering. Now he's got him in half guard. So now he's actually starting to trying to pass the guard of Aung Lai and work into a better position. Pops the hips up. But Aung Lai does a very good job of regaining that butterfly guard. Now he's back almost into full guard. Yep, now he's got full guard, pulling Bigdash back down. But man, he's got to open up his legs and create more movement. Maybe use the wall to try to get back up. Because this is not where he wants to be for the next 4 minutes.
Well, he did try for a moment, but it's so difficult to get the leg up there and then be able to get enough angle to push himself off and create some space. His head pops up there, and it doesn't look any better than it looked in the previous round, does it? Vitaly Bigdash now with the bit between his teeth. And that was a very damaging elbow across the head. And Aung Lutung-sung felt that, and this could be the beginning of the end. Yuki Shimada moves round so that he can get a good view of things. 3:39 left in the fourth. So durable, though, isn't he? Just when you think he's ripe for the taking, the Burmese python shows us his strength.
To take a fight of this magnitude on such short notice definitely displays the heart of Aung Lutung-sung, but he is just taking a beating on the ground here from Bigdash. Big knees to the body.
And then to the temple, and then upstairs with the punches. Aung Lutung-sung on his feet, and he has enough about him to try and go for the trip, but it wasn't executed well enough. Indeed, it's Bigdash who gets it. 3 minutes left in this round now.
The only good thing about this position for Aung Lutung-sung is that he's near his corner, so he can hear the instruction of his coaches very clearly, and he's actually abiding by a lot of what they're saying.
He's got Bigdash's left arm pretty much under control. Sorry, right arm, but it's the left that's doing the damage.
I think that's Bigdash's doing. He's just using his shoulder to pin Aung Lai into that position so he can drop bombs with both sides now.
Yeah, sure enough, Mitch, you're right, because he released it with some ease and dug in that punch with the right hand to the side of the body. Halfway through, just over this fourth round.
Oh, nice sweep there from Aung Lai. Aung Lai got the butterfly hook in and was able to use it to stand back up, but just gets manhandled back down to the ground.
It's clear who has the strength at close quarters, isn't it? Vitaly Bigdash, such a strong man. It's looking like a real struggle now from the fighter from Myanmar.
But Aung Lutung-sung has got a very good guard. He's got a very active guard, and he's using it very well. So once he gets the hooks in, so he releases the full guard position, the closed guard that he's got, he's able to use his legs quite well to create positions that are a little bit better for him, to create a scramble to possibly get back up to his feet.
Those distracting Action! Punches to the left side of Aung Lutung-sung's body, hoping that the arm will come down to block them so that Vitaly can then switch up to the head and do even more damage there. 1:26 left in the fourth. It's looking like Aung Lutung-sung needs something very special, something like a knockout if he's going to win this. As you said, Mitch, he's getting instruction from his corner, but how much good is it doing him? So dominant is Vitaly Bigdash.
You know, it helps. It helps a lot to hear that encouragement from your corner, but there's nothing he can do. Bigdash is so strong in the top position that he's just holding there, and he's just dropping big bombs.
He's just working and working and landing and punishing. That's the mark of the world middleweight champion. Let's hope we don't have to wait 13 months to see him again. Same could be said for Aung Lutung-sung. But how injury-free can he remain?
30 seconds left. No
grubs. It looks like the injuries are just superficial damages to the face. He seems to be moving quite well, fine. He's just being outpowered here. He's just being out-grappled because the bigger, stronger man, Bigdash, is holding him down and, you know, just beating him up.
Just digging in those punches.
There's an armbar.
Right-handed. Here we go.
See, he's still got a very active guard. He's still threatening submissions. He's trying for sweeps. He's doing very well off his back, but he's just getting out-muscled.
He's got an awful lot about him, hasn't he, Aung Lutung-sung? But his big chance is going to come at the start of this fifth round when they're in the stand-up, because when they go to the deck, Bigdash just is in charge.
since the high kick, it's just been more of the same. Rich, what do you have?
Well, I'll tell you, Big Dash has extended his lead so much that I believe that Aung La is going to have to finish the fight in order to win this thing. I don't think he can win it by decision at this point in time. And I believe that it would be smart for him to stay off of his back because of all the blood, it makes him very slippery. And no matter how active his guard is, it's going to be very difficult to land a submission. So if I were in his corner, stay up on my feet, or if I'm going to hit the ground, make sure I end up on top. Otherwise, this fight is going to end up being Big Dash's in 5 minutes.
5 minutes separates Vitaly Big Dash from having that middleweight championship belt strapped around his waist again, unless, as Rich Franklin has just said, Aung La and Sung does something very special, and that surely has to come in the shape of a knockout or a submission. As we said, the best chance comes now. Every round starts on its feet. Once we go down to the mat, you have to fancy that Big Dash will take control again. Crucial 5 minutes for Aung La and Sung, and these early moments are going to be surely the most important. They touch gloves in center cage. The final round of this one championship middleweight world title fight.
And that is a grin of a veteran.
Oh, he got caught throwing that right hand and stumbled.
Big kicks thrown by Vitaly Big Dash again.
This really is the moment where the Burmese fighter has to do something special. But Big Dash knows that, and he's not going to dive in. There's no reason for him to.
Very relaxed, big, nice composure shown by Big Dash, who's throwing some heavy heat with those legs, though. Each thud is just a thunderous shot. Even when Aung La and Sung is able to block it, you can just hear the thud.
Must be tempting, Mitch, for Big Dash to unleash big bombs in the stand-up, but realistically, he probably wants to get Aung La and Sung back down on the mat where he's been in so much control.
Yeah, but he's only going to win a decision that way. You know, Aung La is doing too good a job keeping the full guard, keeping control, not and just taking damage. I think Big Dash wants to get the finish here. He wants to get a knockout. Then that's what he's looking for right now, by throwing some of these heavy shots with his kicks.
Therein lies the risk, though. He provides an opportunity for Aung La and Sung to perhaps get back with one enormous blow. He's got that ability, hasn't he? Got TKOs to his name, 7 of them.
Aung La still in this fight though, nice and just moving nice and well, back and forth on his feet. Big Dash is picking his shots, throwing just one shot at a time, not really putting any combinations together. He's not throwing hands and then the kicks. He's just kind of throwing these big kicks by themselves. And a veteran like Aung La, it's going to be hard to catch him like that. He caught him in the third round with that big left kick because he was putting it together with other shots. Here he is back on the ground.
There's the trip with 250 left in this final round. You have to feel that if Big Dash can just maintain this position, he can coast to victory. His 8-0 record would become 9-0 and he would retain that belt. But you made that point, Mitch. He'd love to end it in spectacular fashion.
I don't think Big Dash is a guy that wants to coast to victory. I think he's always for the victory. I don't think, you know, I think he wants to put a punctuation on his title defense here. His first one, they say you're not a champion until you defend your belt. And he's doing a great job of it here right now. He's out. His game plan is working perfectly against Aung La and Sung.
More of the same. Down come the elbows and the forearms from that very potent left arm. Entering the final 2 minutes of this contest.
2 minutes left.
You're watching one of the most powerful men on the One Championship roster, pound for pound. Vitaly Big Dash doing the business. That time, the right elbow.
The kicks of Big Dash on the feet and the elbows on the ground have been the story of this fight. Just doing significant damage to Aung La and Sung on the ground here.
Tremendously well conditioned.
He's using the cage to try to get back up. You know, but let's see, look at the way Big Dash pulls the hand away, pivots Aung La away from the cage so he's not able to walk back up.
OK, looking for the up kick there, the heel in the face, but Bigdash was more than able to back off and out of range, comes down with that thudding right hand to the side of the face. About to enter the final minute of this 25-minute contest.
1 minute.
Rich Franklin said that Aung and Sung needed to do something special, and by that we need a knockout or a submission win. He has to stop Bigdash surely now if he's to get that belt. 40 seconds left. And it's hard to see how the Burmese Python can reverse this position in the time that he has and do anything significant. But another absolutely formidable exhibition of powerful mixed martial arts from this strong, strong man. 4 KOs, 4 submissions on his record in that unbeaten 8-0 record. Looks like we're going to add his first decision victory as he moves towards retaining his world middleweight crown. As you'd expect, honor and respect in the cage, but just visibly, you can see how this fight has gone. Vitaly Bigdash gets to his feet. Aung and Sung stays in a seated position and looks a very marked man.
And like I said, on the feet, these kicks have been the story. Just landing some punishing shots in the clinch. He was able to control, land big short strikes, a little bit of dirty boxing, and then on the ground, whereas where the majority of the second half of this fight took place, just punishing Aung Sung with those short elbows and controlling the ground game.
A clear contender for the Burger King fight of the night. Rich Franklin, I don't suppose you got anything surprising for us in terms of who you think is going
to
win.
Like I said at the end of the last round, Aung would have to finish this fight in order to win, obviously. That didn't happen. This will be Vitaly's first decision, and he should have the victory here.
A tremendous champion to watch. Look forward to seeing more. It's been a very valiant effort from Aung and Sung. Here's the official decision then from Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of intense battle, we turn now to our judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored in favor for your winner by unanimous decision and still 1 middleweight world champion, Vitaly!